Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss exercise 2 of A of mathematical induction. If you didn't watch the previous videos, the link is in the description, watch it. In this exercise 2 of A, already we discussed the first question in the previous video. Just have a look at that. Now in this video, I'm going to discuss from the second. Okay, the question is, show that 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 5 plus and so on is equals to n into n square plus 6n plus 11 divided by 3 by using mathematical induction. Okay, in the given question, he didn't mention the nth term. So, if nth term is given, then only we can able to solve the answer. So, first let us find the nth term of the given one. We will use the nth term of the AP, that is A plus n minus 1 into D. If we observe the first numbers 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So, in this first term is A, that is 2 plus n as usual, n minus 1 into D is nothing but second term minus first term, 3 minus 2, 1, which is equals to 2 plus n minus 1 into 1, n minus 1. So, n as usual, 2 minus 1, 1. So, n plus 1. This is only for this first numbers. Still we have second numbers also. So for the second numbers also, let us find it out now. If we do for second numbers, A value is here 3 plus n minus 1 into common difference. Here 4, here 3, 4 minus 3, 1. So, we get 3 plus n minus 1 into 1, n minus 1. N as usual, 3 minus 1, 2. So, n plus 2. So, the nth term of the given question will be n plus 1 into n plus 2. So, just remember this n plus 1 into n plus 2. Now, just I will change the question according to the nth term now. So, if you observe here, 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus 4 into 5 plus and so on plus nth term we got as n plus 1 into n plus 2, which is equals to n into n square plus 6n plus 11 whole divided by 3. Okay, now we need to solve this by using three steps completely. The first step is basis of induction. In this, we will show that the statement or formula is true for n equals to 1. Next, second step, inductive hypothesis. In this, we will assume that the given formula or statement is true for n equals to k. Next, third step, inductive step. So, based on this second step, we will prove that the given formula or statement is true for k plus 1 also. So, first, let us go with the step 1. In the step 1, S of 1. S of 1 is nothing but sum of the first term. Here first term is 2 into 3. So 2 into 3, that is equals to 6. Now substituting 1 in the place of n. If n equals to 1, here we have formula n into n square plus 6n plus 11 divided by 3. Here wherever we have n, we need to substitute 1 there. So let us substitute now. 1 into 1 square plus 6 into 1 plus 11 whole divided by 3. Let us simplify this. 1 into 1 square is 1 plus 6 1s are 6 plus 11 as it is whole divided by 3, which is equals to 1 into 1 plus 6 7 7 plus 11 18 divided by 3. So if we simplify further, 1 into 18 18 divided by 3, 3 1s are 3 6 are, so that is 6. Now if we compare the two answers, what we got? Yes, of one value is 6, and when we substituted n equals to 1 also, we got the same answer as 6 only. So we can conclude that the statement or the formula is true for n equals to 1. The statement here in this total, wherever I will mention the statement, that is nothing but the formula or the given question, or the formula which is given in the question. The statement is true for n equals to 1. So this is the first step, simply substituting 1 in the place of n. Next, second step. The second step is very easy, nothing will be there in this to do. Assume that, just it is assumption, assume that the statement or formula is true for n equals to k. Now this is the formula which they gave in the question: n into n square plus 6n plus 11 divided by 3. So in the question, wherever we have n, in the place of n we need to substitute k. So here we will get it as k into k square plus 6k plus 11 divided by 3. So this we need to write there. K into k square plus 6k plus 11 whole divided by 3. This is equals to what then? The given question as it is, that is 2 into 3. 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus and so on plus, we have n plus 1 into n plus 2, right? So in the place of n plus 1 into n plus 2, we need to write k plus 1 into k plus 2. K plus 1 into k plus 2. This is second step. Next, let us move to the third step. In the third step, we need to prove that the given statement is true for k plus 1 also. We like to show that the statement or formula is true for n equals to k plus 1. That is to show that simply in the given question, I mean in the formula, wherever we have n, in the place of n we need to substitute k plus 1. So if you observe the question once, in that the given formula is, if I rub these all lines, it will be clear. Okay, done. N into n square plus 6n plus 11 divided by 3. So in the place of n, simply we need to substitute k plus 1. Let us check it out. N into n square plus 6n plus 3, sorry, plus 11 divided by 3. That I'll write it here as a rough. N into n square plus 6n plus 11 whole divided by 3. So now here, wherever we have n, in the place of n we need to substitute k plus 1. Here n is there, so k plus 1 into, here n square is there, so k plus 1 whole square plus, here 6 n is there, so 6 into k plus 1 plus 11 as it is whole divided by 3. Now if we simplify this, Let us check what we will get as the answer. K plus 1 as usual into K plus 1 whole square. If we expand, we get it as K square plus 1 plus 2K plus 6 into K, 6K plus 6 ones are 6 plus 11 as usual whole divided by 3. Next, still if we check any simplification is possible for this, K plus 1 into K square as it is, 2K plus 6K, 8K, 11 plus 6, 17, 17 plus 1, 18, whole divided by 3. So, this is what exactly we need to show in the answer. Then, we can say that it is true for n equals to K plus 1 also. So, just to make it highlight, I'll keep it in a box so that we can understand at every stage whether we got the same answer or not. Okay, now take the given question as it is. 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus and so on plus, actually we will be having n plus 1 into n plus 2. In the formula we have n plus 1 into n plus 2, but in the place of n keeping it k, k plus 1 into k plus 2, k plus 1 into k plus 2 plus. Okay, now observe these numbers clearly. First number is 2, then the next number is 3. So how much we are adding? Plus 1 we are adding. So here this one also we need to add 1 so that we will get the next number, k plus 1 plus 1. Next, the same way, second one if we observe, here the second one is 3 and here it is 4. So here also 1 is added. So here k plus 2 is there. For that k plus 2 we need to add 1 again. K plus 2 plus 1. Okay, now let us check it out. So we get 2 into 3 in plus 3 into 4 plus and so on plus k plus 1 into k plus 2 plus k plus 1 plus 1, k plus 2 into k plus 2 plus 1, k plus 3. So this is what we got. Now from the step 2, if we observe the step 2 clearly, here in the step 2, 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus and so on plus k plus 1 into k plus 2 value is k into k square plus 6k plus 11 divided by 3. So 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 plus and so on plus k plus 1 into k plus 2 value is k into k square plus 6k plus 11 whole divided by 3 from the step 2. Next, plus here this last term I am writing as it is, that is k plus 2 into k plus 3, k plus 2 into k plus 3. Here anyway denominator is not there, so for easy calculation I am making it by 1. Okay, next if you observe, these two are having different denominators, so I will go with the cross multiplication method. So here both the denominators we need to multiply, that is 3 ones are 3, then cross multiplication. 1 into k square plus 6k plus 11, if we multiply with 1 nothing will change, so as it is k into k square plus 6k plus 11 plus 3 into k plus 2 into k plus 3. So 3 into k plus 2 into k plus 3. Okay, still let us simplify. K into k square plus 6k plus 11 plus 3 into k into k, k square plus k into 3, 3k, 2 into k, 2k plus 2 into 3, 6, whole divided by 3 as usual. Okay, next. k into k square, k power 3 plus k into 6k, 6k square plus k into 11, 11k plus 3 into k square, 3k square plus 3 into 3k, 9k plus 3 into 2k, 6k plus 3, 6, 18 whole divided by 3. Okay, next. K cube as it is plus 6k square plus 3k square, 9k square. 11k plus 9k, 20k plus 6k, 26k plus 18 whole divided by 3. So now we need to do prime factorization of this cubic polynomial which is there in the numerator. So that will be k plus 1 into k square plus 8k plus 18 whole divided by 3. If you doesn't know how to do the factorization of the cubic polynomial, I did one more video on that. The link is in the description. Please go through that. Actually, that is the basic topic in the 10th class. So that's why I'm not going to waste more time for that. Okay, now finally, this is the answer which we got. Now let us compare this answer with what we need to get. This one. Here the answer is visible clearly. K plus 1 into k square plus 8k plus 18 whole divided by 3. Obviously the same answer we got. Then we can conclude this statement or formula is true for n equals to k plus 1 by the principle of mathematical induction. By the principle of mathematical induction, the formula is true for all n belongs to capital N. The question is 1 divided by 1 into 3 plus 1 divided by 3 into 5 plus 1 divided by 5 into 7 plus and so on plus 1 by 2n minus 1 into 2n plus 1 is equals to n divided by 2n plus 1. We need to show this by using mathematical induction. Okay, here nth term is given, so no problem with that. So now directly we can move into the problem, that is step 1. Step 1, S of 1 is equals to, S of 1 is nothing but sum of the first term. So here first term is nothing but 1 divided by 1 into 3. That is equals to 1 by 1 into 3, 3. So sum of the first term is 1 by 3. So now in the given formula, we need to substitute 1 in the place of N. If N equals to 1, here we have the formula N divided by 2N plus 1. So substituting 1 in the place of n, 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus 1, 1 divided by 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, that is nothing but 1 divided by 3. So now if we observe these two answers, when we substituted 1, we got the answer as 1 by 3 and sum of the first term is also 1 by 3 only. So that we can conclude that the statement or the formula is true for n equals to 1. The statement or the formula is true for n equals to 1. This is first step. Now let us move to the second step. The second step is nothing there to solve, just our assumption it is. assume that the statement is true for n equals to k. In the given question, wherever we have n, in the place of n, we need to substitute k. Okay, now if we like check the question once, 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7 plus and so on plus 1 by 2n minus 1 into 2n plus 1. Here n is there, we need to substitute k. Here n is there, we need to substitute k equals to n by 2n plus 1. Here k and here also k we need to substitute. Okay, let us check now. So that is 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5. Plus and so on plus 1 divided by we have 2n minus 1 into 2n plus 1. So we need to substitute 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1. That is equals to right side we have formula n divided by 2n plus 1. Simply in the place of n substituting k. So we get k divided by 2k plus 1. This is step 2. By using this step 2 only, we will solve the step 3 now. Okay, now let us move to the third step. We should show that we like to show that the statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. That is to show that now in the given formula in the place of n we need to substitute k plus 1. Once if you observe the question, we have formula as n by 2n plus 1. For remembering, I'll write it here, that formula n by 2n plus 1. So in the formula, wherever we have n, in the place of n, we need to substitute k plus 1. Here n is there, so substituting k plus 1 divided by 2 into, here n is there, so in the place of n, substituting k plus 1 plus 1 as it is. So now I don't have any work with this. Simplifying equals to k plus 1 whole divided by 2 into k 2k plus 2 1s are 2 plus 1 as it is. Still simplifying further, that is equals to k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 2 plus 1, it is plus 3. So this is actually what exactly we need to show now, that is k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 3. Okay, now let us move to the step 2 once. Here step 2 we have 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus and so on plus 1 by 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1. Write that same step as you see it is 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus and so on plus 1 divided by 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1. Plus, now next term we need to create. What is that term? First, observe here. Here first term is 1 and here first term is 3. So from 1, 2, 3, how many it is increasing? 2 is increasing. So here also numerator is nothing changed. I have 1 as it is. Now here 2k minus 1 is there. This 2k minus 1 should be increased by 2. I think here place is not sufficient. That's why I am writing it down. 1 divided by 2k minus 1 should be increased by 2. Okay, into. Now, if we check the second numbers. Second numbers, if we observe clearly. Here second number is 3 and here second number is 5. So from 3 to 5, what is the difference? That is 2 again. So here 2k plus 1 is there. So for that 2k plus 1 also, we need to add 2 again. Okay. Now, if we move to the second step once, 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus and so on plus 1 by 2k minus 1 into 2k plus 1 value is k divided by 2k plus 1. So in the place of this, I'll substitute k by 2k plus 1. So this is the total one, which is there in the steps 2. So in this place, I will substitute k by 2k plus 1, which is equals to k divided by 2k plus 1 plus. Now this newly written term, I will write it as it is. 1 by 2k minus 1 plus 2 plus 1 into 2k plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. So this we need to solve it now. In the denominators, 2k plus 1 and 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3 is there. So the LCM of these two denominators is 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. Here 2k plus 1 only there, but in the denominator here we have extra 2k plus 3 also. So that's why this k we need to multiply with that extra 2k plus 3. So we get k into 2k plus 3 plus. Here 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3 is there. Here total 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3 is there. So write this numerator as it is without any change. Okay. Now let us simplify this. K into 2k plus 3. K into 2k, it is 2k square, plus k into 3, 3k plus 1 whole divided by denominator as usual. 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3, which is equals to, now I will solve the numerator by splitting the middle term into two terms. 2k square, 3k can be written as 2k plus k plus 1 whole divided by 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. Now in the numerator, from the first and second terms, I will take out 2k common, then we remains with k plus 1. From third and fourth terms, I will take out 1 common, then we remains with k plus 1. Whole divided by 2k plus 1 into 2k plus 3. In the numerator, here k plus 1 is there, here also k plus 1 is there. So write that k plus 1 once, and then remaining numbers, here 2k, here plus 1. So 2k plus 1. Whole divided by denominator as it is 2k plus 1 times 2k plus 3. In the numerator as well as in the denominator, we can cancel 2k plus 1, 2k plus 1. Then we remains with the final answer k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 3. Okay, now let us check whether this is the answer we need to get or not. Okay. Here we did some box very nicely. K plus 1 divided by 2k plus 3. K plus 1 by 2k plus 3. Of course, we got the same answer. So we can say that this statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. This statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. Then by the principle of mathematical induction, by the principle of mathematical induction, the statement or the formula true for all n belongs to natural numbers. The question is, show that 4q plus 8q plus 12q plus and so on up to n terms equals to 16n square into n plus 1 whole square. So in this question, he didn't mention the nth term. In the question, if nth term is given, then it will be very easy to find out the solution. But in this question particularly, he didn't give in the nth term. So for our first duty is to find the nth term of this question. the nth term will be hidden in the question, just we need to find it out. Now observe these numbers, I mean bases, 4, 8, 12. So easily we can say that this is nothing but 4 table. So that is nothing but 4n. Here for every term, cube only is there. So we can write that nth term as 4n whole cube. So just I will modify the question as four cube plus 8 cube plus 12 cube plus and so on plus 4n whole cube equals to 16n square into n plus 1 whole square. Okay, now let us move to the steps. Step 1. S of 1, that is equals to sum of the first term. Here first term is 4 cube. So 4 cube is nothing but 64. Now in the given formula, that is which is there in the RHS, we need to substitute 1 in the place of n. Let us check it out now. N square into n plus 1 whole square is there. So now 16 into, in the place of n substituting 1 square times n is nothing but 1 plus 1 whole square, which is equals to 16 into 1 square is 1 into 1 plus 1 2 square. So which we get 16 ones are 16 into 2 square 4, 16 fours are 64. Now let us check these two answers. S of 1, that is sum of the first term, is also 64 only, as well as when we substituted number 1, then also we got the same answer as 64 only. So that we can conclude this statement is true, or this formula is true for n equals to 1. N equals to 1. This is first step. Now let us move to the second step. In the second step, assume that the statement or formula is true for n equals to k. So it's very simple. In the given question, wherever we have n, in the place of n, we need to substitute k. Okay, now let us move back to question ones. 4 cube plus 8 cube plus 12 cube and so on plus 4n whole cube is there. So the question is 4 cube plus 8 cube plus and so on plus 4n whole cube is there. So in the place of n, substituting k. 4k whole cube is equals to, same in the RHS also. Here RHS we have 16n square into n plus 1 whole square is there. So simply in the place of n, substituting k, we get 16k square into k plus 1 whole square. 16k square into k plus 1 whole square. This is second step. Now by using this second step only, we will solve it further in the third step. In the third step, what we need to do is, we like to show that the statement is true for n equals to k plus 1, that is to show that now in the given formula or in the given question, we have 16n square into n plus 1 whole square. 16n square into n plus 1 whole square. So now in this formula, wherever we have n, in the place of n, we need to substitute k plus 1. So 16 as it is into n square is there. So in the place of n, k plus 1 whole square into, here we have n plus 1. N is nothing but k plus 1 as it is whole square. So if we simplify this, 16 into k plus 1 whole square into k plus 1 plus 2 whole square. So this is what exactly we need to prove. 16 into k plus 1 whole square into k plus 2 whole square. Okay, now let us move to the original solution. In the second step, we have 4q plus 8q plus and so on plus 4k cube. That we will take it 4 cube plus 8 cube plus 12 cube plus and so on plus 4k whole cube plus next term we need to create. Now observe all the bases ones clearly. Here 4, here 8, here 12. So how much it is increasing every time? Plus 4, plus 4, plus 4. It keeps continuous like that only. So here we have 4k. For that also we need to add 4. So then we get 4k plus 4 whole power 3. Okay, now from the second step, 4k plus 8k, sorry, 4 cube plus 8 cube plus and so on plus 4k whole cube value is 16k square into k plus 1 whole square. So this value is nothing but 16k square into k plus 1 whole square plus the next term I'm writing as it is, that is 4k plus 4 whole power 3. Okay, let us start simplifying this now. 16k square into k plus 1 whole square as it is I am writing plus 4k plus 4 whole power 3. From that I will take 4 common, then remains with k plus 1 whole power 3. Next, 16k square into k plus 1 whole square plus this cube is for 4 also as well as for k plus 1 also. So 4 cube into k plus 1 whole cube. K plus 1 whole cube I will write it as k plus 1 whole square into k plus 1. Why like this? Means here k plus 1 whole square is there, here also if k plus 1 whole square is there, means then we can take out common. That is the only reason I wrote it as k plus 1 whole square into k plus 1. Okay, now sixteen k square as it is into k plus 1 whole square plus 4 cube is nothing but 64 into k plus 1 whole square into k plus 1. Okay, now let us take common. Here we can take out 16 into k plus 1 whole square as common. Here 16 completed, k plus 1 whole square completed, then remaining is k square. Write that k square here. Plus k plus 1 whole square completed. Here 16 is there, but here 64 is there. So in 16 table, where we will get 64? 4s are remaining is k plus 1. 4 into k plus 1. Okay. Now let us simplify it further. 16 into k plus 1 whole square into, if I open the bracket here, 4 into k 4k plus 4 into 1 4. Which gives us 16 into k plus 1 whole square into. Now if you observe this clearly, k square plus 4k plus 4, that is in the form of a plus b whole square, that is a square plus b square plus 2ab. So if we simplify that, we will get it as k plus 2 whole square, that is a plus b whole square formula. This is the final answer we got. Now let us check this with our answer, whether this correct one or not. We need to get actually 16 into k plus 1 whole square into k plus 2 whole square. 16 into k plus 1 whole square into k plus 2 whole square. Okay, we got the correct answer. Then we can say that the statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. The statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. So by the method of by the principle of mathematical induction, by the principle of mathematical induction, the statement or the formula is true for all n belongs to natural numbers. The question is a plus d plus a plus 2d plus and so on up to n terms equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, in the given question, if nth term is given, means it will be easy. But in the question, the nth term is not given. So first, our duty is to finding the nth term. Now, observe each and every term once clearly. This is first term, so it is only given as a. That a, I will write it as a plus 0d, because 0 into d also 0 only, and 0 doesn't have any value. Next, this is second term, it is a plus 1d. It is third term, that is a plus 2d. If we observe, this is first term 0d, this is second term 1d, this is third term, this is 2d. Then what will be the nth term? A as it is plus nth term will be n minus 1 into d. So this is the nth term. So now I will just modify the question according to our convenient. That is a plus d plus a plus 2d and so on plus nth term a plus n minus 1 into d equals to right side formula as usual, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, now let us solve this. First step, S of 1 is nothing but sum of the first term. Here first term is only a, so S of 1 is a. Now in the given formula, that is which is there in the RHS, in the place of n, we need to substitute 1. Okay, here n by 2 is there. If n equals to 1, n by 2 is there, so 1 by 2 into 2a plus n is nothing but 1 minus 1 into d, which is equals to 1 by 2 into 2a plus 1 minus 1 0d, which is equals to 1 by 2 into 2a plus 0d, it is 2a. 2 will get cancelled, then we remains with a. Now S of 1 is also a only. When we substituted n equals to 1 also, we got the answer a only. So both the answers are same. Then we can conclude that the statement or the formula is true for n equals to 1. The statement is true for n equals to 1. Now let us move to the second step. In the second step, just we will assume that the formula is true for n equals to k. So in the given question, wherever we have n, we will substitute k in the place of it. Now let's move to question ones. In the question, we have a plus d plus a plus 2d and so on, a plus n minus 1 into d. Here n is there, so here we need to substitute k. Right side also here n is there, k. Here also n is there, substituting k. Okay, now let us move. First terms as usual, a plus d plus and so on plus nth term we have a plus n minus 1 into d. So a plus k minus 1 into d, which is equals to sum of nth terms of AP. We know formula very well, n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. In the place of n, simply I am substituting k. So this is second step. The second step is just assumption. Now the third step, we need to show that the given statement or formula is also true for n equals to k plus 1. We like to show that, or we should show that the formula is true for n equals to k plus 1. That is to show that in the formula, in the place of n, we need to substitute n plus 1. Here we have formula n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, now wherever we have n, we need to substitute k plus 1. Here n is there, so k plus 1 by 2 into 2a plus, again here n is there, so n is nothing but k plus 1 minus 1 as it is into d. Okay, this I don't have any work with now. Okay, so k plus 1 by 2 as it is into 2a plus, here plus 1 minus 1 cancel, so we remains with kd. This is what exactly we need to show now, that is k plus 1 divided by 2 into 2a plus kd. So now let us move to the second step once. In the second step we have a plus d plus and so on plus a plus k minus 1 into d plus. Now observe all the things clearly. Here a, it continues like that only. So in the next term also obviously a will be there. So it's not sufficient, so that's why I'm writing it down. A as it is plus. Now here 0d, here 1d, next 2d, then 3d, then 4d, like that it's continuing only one by one. So here k minus 1 into d is there, means here we will get k into d. Okay, now once let us move to the second step. In the second step we have clearly a plus d plus and so on plus a plus k minus 1 into d. Value is k by 2 into 2a plus k minus 1 into d. So here in the place of this total, I will substitute k by 2 into 2a plus k minus 1 into d from the second step, plus this remaining term I'll write as it is a plus k into d, nothing but kd. Now let us simplify this. K by 2 as it is into 2a plus, I'll open this bracket, k into d kd minus 1 into d 1d, nothing but d, plus a plus kd. Now this bracket also I'm opening, k into 2a k2a plus k into kd k square d minus k into d kd whole divided by 2. And remaining terms as it is plus a plus kd. So now here both the denominators are different, so what we will do means k2a plus k square d minus kd plus 2 into a 2a plus 2 into kd 2kd, then whole divided by 2. Now if any simplification is possible means let us do that simplification. If simplification is not possible means let us do factorization. Here all are completely different terms, so simplification is not possible. Let us do factorization for this now. Now simplification is possible, right? Here 2kd is there, here minus kd is there. Yes, we can simplify. So remaining terms as it is k2a plus k square d plus 2a. Now plus 2kd minus kd plus kd whole divided by 2. Okay. Now let us do factorization. From the first term as well as from the third term, I will take out 2a common, then we remains with k plus 1. The same way from the second term and fourth term, I will take out kd common, then we remains with k plus 1 whole divided by 2. So now in the numerator, here we have k plus 1, here also k plus 1, 2 times is there, so write it once, k plus 1 into here 2a plus kd. 2a plus kd whole divided by 2. So now let us check whether this is only we need to get the answer or something else. Already we know that we need to get this answer, k plus 1 by 2 into 2a plus kd. 2a plus kd into k plus 1 divided by 2. Of course, that is only correct answer. So, the statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. The statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. By the principle of mathematical induction, the statement or formula is true for all n belongs to natural numbers. The question is a plus ar plus ar square plus and so on up to n terms equals to a into r power n minus 1 whole divided by r minus 1, where r not equals to 1. Okay, in this question, nth term is not given. So our first duty is to find the nth term. Okay, let us check how to find this nth term. First term a can be written as a into r power 0, because r power 0 is 1, so a into 1 is as usual a. A into r can be written as a into r power 1. Next ar square, ar cube, ar power 4, it continues like that. So now if we observe here, this is first term, so power 0. Second term power 1. This is third term power 2. Fourth term power 3. So whatever the term number, we need to subtract 1 so that we will get that particular term. So the same way we want nth term now. So nth term means the power will be n minus 1. So a into r power n minus 1. Nth term of geometric progression this is. Okay, now I will modify the question according to our convenience. A plus AR plus AR square plus and so on plus nth term we got as a into r power n minus 1, which is equals to a times r power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Okay, now let us move to our steps. First step, s of 1 equals to, s of 1 is nothing but sum of the first term. Here first term is a, so simply we cannot simplify further, so s of 1 is a as usual. Now taking the RHS, that is formula, a into r power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. In this formula, wherever we have n, I will substitute 1 if n equals to 1. A into r power n is this, that is r power 1 minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Now, which is equals to a into r power 1 is nothing but r minus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. In the numerator as well as denominator, r minus 1 will get cancelled. So, we remains with a. Now, if we observe these two answers, s of 1 also a only, as well as when we substituted 1 in the place of n, then also we got answer a only. So that we can conclude this statement is true for n equals to 1. The statement is true for n equals to 1. Now, let us move to the second step. Second step is just assuming. Assume that the statement is true for, or the formula. Assume that the formula or statement is true for n equals to k. Now in the given question, wherever we have n, we need to substitute that n by k. Let us check. Now we have a plus ar plus ar square plus and so on plus ar power n minus 1, a plus ar plus and so on plus, we have a into r power n minus 1, a into r power in the place of n, k minus 1, which is equals to, right side also if you observe the formula, we have a into r power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. So a into r power n is there, so in the place of n, k minus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. This is step 2, just substituting k in the place of n. Next, third step, We should show that the statement or formula is true for n equals to k plus 1. That is to show that, now in the given formula only RHS part. In the given formula, wherever we have n, we need to substitute k plus 1. Let us check the formula once. We have formula a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. A into r power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Now here, wherever we have n, we need to substitute k plus 1. There, here we have n. So in the place of n, substituting k plus 1. A as it is into r power n is nothing but k plus 1 minus 1 as usual whole divided by r minus 1. So this is what exactly we need to get in the answer. Okay, now let us move to the second step once. In the second step, we have a plus ar plus ar square and so on plus ar power k minus 1. I'll write the same as it is. A plus ar plus ar square plus and so on plus a into r power k minus 1 plus. Now next term we need to create. Here observe clearly. Powers, if you observe for r, because a is as usual, it is there. So as it is, r also will be there. Now only power we need to change. here r power 0, here r power 1, r power 2, r power 3, just it is increasing 1 by 1. Here minus 1 is there, so this r power k minus 1 as usual and increasing by 1. Because from the first step onwards it is increasing by 1, so that's why here also we need to increase it by 1. Now if I simplify this further, we will get it as this total value, we can write it from the second step, that is a into r power k minus 1 divided by r minus 1, a into r power k minus 1 divided by r minus 1 plus a into r power, here minus 1 plus 1 both cancel, so remains with k. Now a into r power k minus 1 plus, here denominator is not there for the second term, so simply multiplying, that is r minus 1 into a r power k, r minus 1 into a r power k whole divided by r minus 1. Okay, now I will expand all. A into r power k, a r power k minus a into 1 a plus r into a r power k into r minus 1 into a r power k whole divided by r minus 1. Okay, now in the numerator, let us check for any cancellation is possible or not possible. If it is possible, means definitely we need to cancel. If not possible, means we will move to the further step. Here plus ar power k minus ar power k, both will get cancelled. Then what we remains? Here ar power k into r is there, that r is nothing but r power 1. So we remains with minus a plus a into, here r power k into r power 1, both the bases are same, so we can add the powers, r power k plus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. Now in the numerator, from the first term as well as from the second term, I will take out a common, then we remains with minus 1 plus r power k plus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. A into, here minus 1 is the starting, so that's why I'm just interchanging the terms, r power k plus 1 minus 1 whole divided by r minus 1. So finally, after simplification or solving everything, I got this answer. Let us check whether we got the correct answer or not. Actually, we need to get this one, that is a into r power k plus 1 minus 1 divided by r minus 1, and we got this one, a into r power k plus 1 minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Obviously, both answers are same, so then we can conclude that the statement is true for n equals to k plus 1. So by the principle of mathematical induction, the statement is true for n belongs to natural numbers.